Hello, today we are going to make hedgehog. Inflate brown balloon leaving about 8 inch flat tail. We are going to use this balloon to make the head, legs and belly of the hedgehog. Twist the first soft thumbnail sized bubble to make the nose. Lock both ends of the first bubble in one lock twist. Also, there is another way to make the nose using a tulip twist and one small black bubble. I will explain it to you later. Twist the second about 2 inch bubble. Twist the third soft about 2 inch bubble. Twist the fourth soft about 1 inch bubble. Lock both ends of the fourth bubble in one lock twist. Twist the fifth soft about 2 inch bubble. Lock both ends of the chain of the last 3 bubbles in one lock twist. We have made the head as a front view. Twist the sixth about 1 inch bubble, twist the 7th soft about 1 inch bubble, lock both ends of the 7th bubble in one lock twist, we have made the first front leg. Twist the 8th 2 inch bubble, twist the 9th soft about 1 inch bubble, lock both ends of the 9th bubble in one lock twist, twist the 10th 1 inch bubble, 11th 1 inch bubble, 12th soft about 1 inch bubble, lock both ends of the 12th bubble in one lock twist, twist the 13th 2 inch bubble, twist the 14th soft about 1 inch bubble, lock both ends of the 14th bubble in one lock twist. At the same time we have to hold the 10th and 11th bubble from unfolding. Twist the 15th about 1 inch bubble. Now we have to lock both ends of the chain of the last 10 bubbles in one lock twist. So basically we have made the head with legs and body. Or we can use the rest of the balloon as a handle or use it to make a belly and the tail. Well, I'm not sure if hedgehog have a tail. Well, anyway, I'm gonna make it. So let's twist the 16th about 2 inch, 3 inch long bubble. Lock the free end of the 16th bubble between the 10th and 11th bubble. We can use the rest of the balloon to make the long tail or twist some small bubble to make small short tail. Cut off the rest of the balloon and tie off the end. Alright, so we have made the body of the hedgehog and we can use the same body to make a sculpture of turtle and maybe to make some other animals as well. In this example, the 7th the 9th, the 12th and the 14th bubble represent legs. In this example I'm going to use a gray balloon to make the top part of the hedgehog's body. Inflate the gray balloon leaving about 8 inch flat tail. Tie the nozzle of the gray balloon between the 10th and the 11th brown bubbles or at the base of the tail. Twist the first gray about 1 inch bubble. Lock the free end of the first gray bubble with one of the rear leg bubbles. Twist the next two gray about 1 inch bubbles. So as you can see we basically work the gray balloon around the hedgehog's body. Lock the free end of the third gray bubble with the nearest front leg. Twist the chain of the next two gray about 1 inch bubbles. Lock the free end of the fifth gray bubble with the fourth brown bubble. As you can see, we twist all gray bubbles of about the same 1 inch size. Twist the chain of the next two gray bubbles. Lock the free end of the seventh gray bubble with the other front leg bubble. Twist the chain of the next two gray bubbles. And then we lock the free end of the 9th gray bubble with the nearest brown rear bubble. Twist the 10th gray bubble. Lock both ends of the chain of the first and the last 10 gray bubbles in one lock twist. Okay, we have made the first row. Let's fix all bubbles in proper positions to get better view. Here's a top view, here's a side view and the bottom view. And here's the front view. Now we're going to work the second row around the body. Twist the chain of the next three gray bubbles. Lock both ends of the chain of the last seven gray bubbles in one lock twist. We have to force the end of the gray balloon between the body, the brown body, and the sixth and the seventh gray bubbles. Twist the chain of the next two gray bubbles. And then we lock both ends of the chain of the last nine gray bubbles in one lock twist. Again, this time we have to force the end of the gray balloon between the body and the fourth and the fifth gray bubbles. And now we twist a chain of the next three gray bubbles. We're working our way back to the tail of the hedgehog. And now we lock both ends of the chain of the last eight gray bubbles in one lock twist. Actually, I lock the free end of the 18th gray bubble with the last brown bubble, the tail of the hedgehog. This way it's faster and easier. So here's a side view, the top front view, the front view, the top view. And now we work the last row of the body. Twist the chain of the next two gray bubbles. Lock both ends of the chain of the last six gray bubbles in one lock twist. We have to force the end of the gray balloon between the 14th and the 15th gray bubbles. Twist the chain of the next two gray bubbles. And now we lock the free end of the last, the 22nd gray bubble, with the last brown bubble, the tail of the hedgehog. Also, we can say that we lock both ends of the chain of the first or the last 22 gray bubbles in one lock twist. I hide the rest of the gray balloon, hiding it by forcing inside between gray bubbles of the body. Actually, we can leave it outside and use it instead of the tail. It's all up to you. Let's fix all bubbles in proper positions. Once again, in this example, we twist all gray bubbles of the same, about 1 inch size. So the body of the hedgehog in this example doesn't come out exactly as much rounded as you may want. Well, we can twist, of course, bubbles of different size to give the body a more rounded shape, as you wish. In this case, it probably would take more than one gray balloon. Well, anyway, I think that's good enough for simple hedgehog. Now let's use a permanent black marker to draw the face, the eyes. And then we paint the nose, the first brown bubble. You can draw the legs if you want. I'm gonna do that. Also, we can use small 1 inch black bubbles instead of painting nose and the legs. And here the mouse. Alright, congratulations, we have made the simple hedgehog. In the next example, we're going to make basically the same hedgehog. Twist black soft about 1 inch bubble. Tie both ends of the black bubble securely. Leave at least 2 inch black tail. Twist the first brown thumbnail size bubble. We're going to use it to make the tulip twist. Lock the free end of the first brown bubble with a flat tail of the black bubble. Make sure to have at least 1 inch flat tail between the black and brown bubble. Force the first brown bubble about 2 inch inside of the brown balloon. Make sure to leave the black bubble outside of the brown balloon. There are a couple slightly different ways to make basically the same tulip twist. We have discussed it in many previously published instructions. If you need more help to make tulip twist, you can look up links to the instructions at our website, fewdoit.com. The rest of the sculpture will work in exactly the same fashion as we did the first hedgehog. So I'm just going to fast play the rest part of the video. Again, I want to remind you that we can use a black balloon to make the leg bubbles. It could be the same size black bubbles as we use for the nose in this example. Here on the left you can see the example of the first body, where we use a brown balloon to make the nose bubble. On the right side of your screen is a sculpture where we use tulip twist to attach the black bubble nose. Let's make the second hedgehog. Again, I'm going to use a gray color balloon to make the top of the body. Of course, we can use different color balloons to make hedgehog. In nature, hedgehogs come in different colors, and we don't have to stick with the natural colors in balloon twisting, right? We can use pink, yellow, blue to make the Sonic hedgehog. Nice cartoon character, right? Let's get back to our sculpture. We have made 13 gray bubbles. Lock both ends of the chain of the last 7 gray bubbles in one lock twist. From here I'm going to work in slightly different ways. The result is going to be exactly the same sculpture. Twist the chain of the next 3 bubbles and lock both ends of the chain of the last 6 bubbles in one lock twist. Twist the chain of the next 3 bubbles and lock both ends of the chain of the last 15 bubbles in one lock twist. Twist the next, 20th gray bubble. And then we lock both ends of the chain of the last 6 gray bubbles in one lock twist. And now we twist the chain of the last 2 gray bubbles. Lock the free end of the last, the 22nd gray bubble, with the last brown bubble. Alright, and again we can use the rest of the gray balloon as a tail. Or we can cut it off and tie off the end. As in previous example, I'm just gonna hide the rest of the gray balloon inside of the gray body. Just force it between the bubbles. Let's fix all bubbles in proper positions. As you can see, the hedgehog body is exactly the same as in the first example. Again, I'm using a permanent black marker to draw the eyes and the mouth. Congratulations, we have made the second hedgehog. Alright, now we can take a closer look on both hedgehogs that we have made today. Here's a side view, top view, the front view, the bottom view. As you can see, the only difference is the nose. Here's a back view. Alright, it should be enough for today. Have fun and happy twisting!